The latest remarks by Iebc boss Wafula Chebukati warning the candidates with no degrees to be left out in the coming 2022 polls has erupted a political storm. A group of the members of the county assemblies under the county assemblies forum and a few members of parliament have threatened to move to court should Wafula Chebukati implement the law which has been postponed for the last 10 years.
Kuna wengi wako na shahada. Nani kama ni maziwa lala, hakuna kitu wanaongezea. Na kuna wengi ambao hawana shahada na wanachangia vizuri na wanaongoza kwa vizuri.
Osman Ibrahim the Isli North Ward Rep, a Lego Songa member of parliament Samatande, and Chris Wamal of Kiminini say leadership is not all about academic qualifications.
Kwa sababu mimi nimeona watoto yangu nimepeleka shule na nikaona ya kwamba ile shahada watu wanapewa ni bure kabisa, haina afadhali hata diploma kutoka nje.
And there's no evidence that if you have many papers then probably you have more integrity than the others. Many of us have gone to school and we have many papers, but when it comes to interrogation and decision making, the education level does not apply.
Let's give a listening so that you'll be able to know leadership is not only about academic qualifications, Mr. Speaker.
Anthony Manyara, Nairobi University student, had petitioned Parliament to have the 2022 Elections Act repealed on claims it's unconstitutional. But as the aggrieved members of the county assemblies contemplate moving to court to have the law quashed, learned members of the county assemblies led by Peter Warutere of Roysambu and Moses Ogeto of Kiminini got support from the majority of the members of Parliament, who say it's high time the leaders possess bachelor's degree as a minimum qualification to contest for an elective seat.
Yeah, education is a key factor, because if you see the debates and even the budgets which are being brought before the assembly, they are in figures. So if you bring a class A dropout and you bring for him a budget of like Nairobi County, you are talking about 38 billion, he doesn't understand what is a 38 billion budget.
The requirement for the legislators to have a degree was first enacted in the Elections Act of 2011 and was to apply in the year 2013 general election. However, a majority of the members of the parliament who did not have a degree at that time successfully lobbied the then President Mwai Kibaki and Prime Minister Raila Odinga, and the clause was suspended for 5 years. Come the year 2017 polls, members of the parliament were at it again and voted to provide a transition clause in the act, a push for its implementation in the 2022 polls.
And the degree, in fact, the degree must be verifiable, and you must come with a transcript. You cannot just come and not hundreds of degrees. There are people in this house who are called doctors and they have got 100 degrees. That is not a degree.
And so we are just extending this to ensure that those who come to this house don't stay here for 4 years and don't say anything. The Speaker, we have members in this house who go for 5 years and they claim we worked on the ground.
Legislators argue part of the challenges affecting the performance of the county assemblies and the parliament is attributed to the academics.
I am making the arc. I'm telling you, ruin is coming. Please take cover. And you are not taking cover. Let's reach 2022 is when you will know that I was a prophet. Mr. Speaker, that hour of reckoning has now come. Those MCAs who are saying Badi is abusing us, now you should know that Badi was their friend. If you still don't have a degree, please, it is too bad for you.
And you saw the amount of money that was allocated to education, Mr. Speaker. So we will be making a mockery of education in this house if we can accept that someone can come into this dignified house without a degree.
For us basically to registrate and to deal with policy issues, we need an educated mind.
Nairobi County Assembly, Kisumu, Nyamira, among others, for a long time has witnessed dramatic scenes of infightings among the members of the county assemblies. It is said 3/4 of the members of the county across the country are likely to be affected should the law be implemented to the latter. Reporting for Ebro TV, I'm Jeff Khaemba.